Welcome everybody to Game Sushi. Today I'm going to show you some different examples of performance when we have rebar disabled versus enabled. And yes, there are benchmark videos you can watch that have nice looking graphs to show you what performance is like on different games and what it's like turned off versus turned on. But that's just half the story. As I mentioned in my Should You Buy an Arc GPU video, depending on the game you're playing, you may take an FPS hit by not having it turned on, and sure, not that big of a deal, but in other instances, it could be worse than that, hence why I'm making this video. By the way, if you haven't watched my Should You Buy an Arc GPU video yet, make sure you go over there and check it out, especially if you are considering buying one of these cards. There's a lot of stuff in there that I feel is really important that should factor into your decision on whether or not you should buy one. So for this rebar test, I thought it'd be really fun to take two specific examples here. Shoddy PC port on one hand, and a super well-optimized game on the other. We're going to be testing with Last of Us and Doom Eternal. First up though, Last of Us, which if you don't know, is a PlayStation exclusive, or at least it was until recently. Now, when it launched, it had a whole host of issues, and a lot of people with older GPUs or GPUs around 8 gigabytes of VRAM, some with 10, were having a really tough time playing it. Now, I myself with the A770 actually at launch had a pretty good time. Sure, I could tell that things could be optimized better, but I could actually play the game. Let me prove that to you real quick before we get into our test. So here's my Reddit post from 2 months ago when the game launched, day of. I thought it'd be cool to just take video of my ultra-wide monitor, and this is how excited I was. I said that this is the way I've always wanted to play Last of Us. Rebar is off, so sorry it looks so choppy. Now for the settings I'm using, I changed everything to medium, hit apply, then I just went back and changed the textures to high. Whether I left them on medium or high, it wouldn't have made that much difference performance-wise. The A770 has no problem handling larger textures. It just looks better, so that's why I did that. And FSR, I have set to balance. I just wanted to showcase the scene outside, because there's a lot of grass, trees, a lot of foliage, and generally that's a lot harder on the card. But then also we're going to take a look at a combat scene where there's different particle effects and, you know, I'm kind of setting things on fire. And while it's indoors, and generally there'll be a better frame rate indoors in this game, there's still a lot going on here, so I just wanted to show you that. And pay attention to these frame rate numbers and what the graph looks like, because later on when I show this with rebar on, it'll pretty different. Another thing I want to mention is that capturing an OBS gives me a minus 10 FPS decrease generally. In Cyberpunk, that was the case. So we can safely assume that if I wasn't capturing an OBS while playing the game, we would be 10 FPS higher. And while, you know, it does look pretty choppy, it would be a more playable experience. And, you know, there's not as many stutters as I thought there would be, to be honest. This being a not well-optimized game, after all.
Thank you.
Now rebar is on, same settings. And you'll notice that even though FPS isn't that much better, again, you have to factor in, if I wasn't capturing in OBS, we'd be 10 FPS higher. And really, the thing to pay attention to is that frame time graph. Even outside, it's smoother than it was before. And once we get into the action scenes, you will see it is much smoother. So given that we'd be 10 FPS higher and really a non-stuttery experience at a lower FPS is going to feel a lot smoother than, you know, you being at a higher FPS, but there's just a lot of stutters, which you would feel anytime you try to move your character, move the camera around. It's kind of like it gets stuck for a second, and then, you know, you see the image update, or you feel the responsiveness back in the mouse where previously it was like herky jerky. Having rebar on is crucial. So I'm going to let this play out, but I'm really excited to get to the Doom Eternal one, because the results are not going to be what you think. Now, this is literally footage of me trying to capture while rebar is off with Doom Eternal. I couldn't even really launch the game with OBS capturing, and so I turned OBS off, launched the game. It was actually a very weird experience. The menu was like super slow. And then when I quickly tried to switch over to OBS and turn that on, it just like kind of froze. So here we have the most well-optimized game currently, and with rebar off, I can't even capture with OBS. Now, I was able to test by turning OBS off and just seeing what the gameplay experience was like. I can tell you that it felt like I was only getting around 12 FPS. That's a completely unplayable experience. You just kind of have to imagine what that was like, and really, it wouldn't even be worth showing you what that was like. So this is what I mean when I say not having rebar turned on is more than just taking an FPS hit, because depending on what game you're playing, like even in Last of Us, for crying out loud, there was an FPS hit and really not that big of a deal in that game, surprisingly. Yet on this game, the most optimized game, like I said, currently, without rebar, I couldn't even get the thing to really function properly. So here is footage of what it was like when rebar was turned on. I'm sorry, I forgot to turn on Afterburner, so you can't see what frame rate I'm currently getting. And I apologize for that. I forgot to do that with just how much I was struggling to try and capture when rebar was off, so it just slipped my mind. But I think the results are clear enough for you to see that since I couldn't even capture the footage when rebar was off, that you forgive me a little bit. It's plain to see here that I am getting my maximum frames per second that I could get. My monitor is a 144 hertz refresh rate monitor. I just capped mine to 144, and I'm certainly getting that. And just from trying this game out with my A770, when I first got the card back in February, I can tell you that you'll get max frames. Like, you really don't need much to run this at over 100 FPS, so don't even worry about it. So, anyway, that was just a really surprising result. I really was not expecting that. If anything, I was expecting for Doom Eternal to actually behave pretty well without rebar. But that's not Doom Eternal's fault. It's just a quirk of this card, where rebar or SAM is optional on AMD or NVIDIA. It is not optional here. You must have it turned on if you're planning to do any gaming. So if you are interested in buying the Alchemist lineup of cards, whether it's the A770 you're looking at, the A750, A380, if you can't enable rebar, I would highly suggest you just get something else. Well, I hope you liked this and found it entertaining. Now you have more of a feel of some at least wacky examples of what having rebar enabled versus disabled might actually feel like. Again, these are very extreme examples, shoddy PC port versus most well-optimized game. And look at how unpredictable that was, right? So depending on what kind of game you're playing, yeah, it might not be a big of a deal, or it might unexpectedly not even run right without rebar. And with that said, I do have some news here. I'm actually going to be taking a break from this card for a little bit. Again, I love it. And that's the thing about love, right? It doesn't have to make sense. Just ask Johnny Depp and Amber Heard. Okay, that got really dark. Now, I'm not getting rid of it, so don't think that. I'm just kind of switching to something else for a little bit. Let me show you what I picked up. I don't even know if I can get this in the camera here. Yeah, I picked up a 6800 XT. I haven't had an AMD card for a very long time. My last one was a 7970, I think made by Diamond. Now, I'm somebody that likes to tinker. In fact, one of my favorite things to do is take a old Optiplex, Dell Optiplex, basically an old workstation machine, where basically somebody was trying to get rid of this, and I managed to snag it up. It actually has a factory Dell power supply with an extra 6-pin PCI connector, which meant that if I paired that with a GPU that didn't have any crazy power requirements, this would make a great first time gaming PC for one of my kids. And that's exactly what I did. You can see a little dinosaur I painted on the front. But yeah, I like doing things like that. And oh, by the way, you can use an aftermarket power supply with these things, but depending on what the power connector on the motherboard is, it's either an 8-pin or a 6-pin. I don't know, it just kind of depends. And you would have to use the right kind of adapter to go from a normal ATX motherboard power connector to a Dell one. And if you guys are interested in that kind of thing, let me know and I can kind of give you the rundown on this particular build and how I did that. And I'm bringing this up because, I like to tinker around, and while I'm not completely getting rid of the A770, I just need to take a break from it for a little bit. And I'm gonna try out the 6800 and play some games. And I may eventually throw the A770 into one of my kids' PCs, although obviously I can't do that in the machine I showed on screen because, Anyway, and I'm bringing that up just to let you know that it may be a little bit before you see another Arc-related video from me. GPU prices across the board have been getting a lot better. And now that I have a super ultra-wide and high refresh rate, 2560 by 1440 monitor on top of that, I wanted something that I could consistently run at different resolutions without, having to turn too many things down. That's why I did that. So I'm still really invested in the future of Arc. I really want Intel to do well. And when Battlemage comes out, I'm going to be picking one of those up and doing some benchmark videos. So that'll be interesting to see. Anyway, if you like this video, please hit the like button and please subscribe. Again, I thank everybody that watches the videos, hits the like button, drops a comment, and I just can't express how thankful I am to everybody that's stopped by and checked out the channel. And with that, let me leave you with something a little humorous here. A few days ago, I did a poll, and the poll said, "The RTX 4060 Ti launches tomorrow. Are you interested in it or any of the 4060 series cards?" 14 of you participated, and no was 93%. And only a few of you, or one of you, said, "Don't know anything about them." So I'm really glad that I didn't buy one of those in hopes that you guys would be interested in seeing that. Thank you for allowing me to dodge that bullet. And with that said, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.